Hello and Happy New Year. Patrick Walchuk here with an update on real estate in Orleans to the end of January 2017. One of these numbers may not appear to make sense, but we double-checked them and they are accurate, so we'll get right into it. For residential properties, when we look at rows and semi-detached, the sales of those for the first month of this year compared to the first month of 2016 is down 33%. But don't be too concerned about that because it's early days and what we're really talking about is only 24 homes sold, okay? So anyhow, that number percentage-wise looks huge. The average price of a row and a semi is a little over $300,000, which is a decline of about 1.5%. For detached homes in Orleans, sales are down 5.5%, and that represents 34 homes sold, by the way, compared to 36 last year. The average price is almost $412,000, and that's a decline in prices of about 2.5%. So when we take these and all other types of houses, what we're looking at is a decline in sales of 20% this year, and the average price is $365,705, and we're up marginally about 0.5%. So when we look further at condominiums, for townhouses or rows and the semis, the number of condos sold in Orleans is down 20% compared to this time last year. The average condo price for this type of housing stock is $223,000, which is an increase of 6%, which is terrific for condos. Now for apartments and stacked are basically a condo with two floors, and the average price is almost $195,000, which is a decline of 5.2%. And again, we're talking really, really small numbers, even though the percentages are huge. There's only been four of this type of housing stock and four of this type of housing stock sold. So you can see the totals here. We're down about 47% in terms of the numbers sold, and prices are up almost 1% at an average of $209,000. So I would also like to just tell you about the highest price and the lowest price residential homes that have sold in Orleans in the first month of 2017. So the lowest price property was in Orleans Woods, and it was a row unit, as you might expect. It had three bedrooms, and it sold for $250,000. The highest price was in Chapel Hill. That was a detached house with four bedrooms, and it sold for $642,000. In the world of condominiums, in Convent Glen North, we had a condo apartment, a one bedroom, that sold for $177,000. And to finish things off, the highest priced condo that sold was also in Chapel Hill, and it was a row unit, three bedrooms, three bathrooms, and it sold for $255,000.